Absolutely. If you call, you know, what they call redlining, I mean, you know, that's a slang term and whatnot. It could be white lining. I don't know, you know. But somebody called it that. But it just, all it is just restrictions like you have in any prison system.
Mm-hmm.
You people go over here. This will be your section of time. We usually, after we get there, we call it a black community. That's not a community. The community has power. Black people are assigned where they're going to be. And we think a whole bunch of black people who are bunched together at a certain geographical location automatically makes the community.
Yeah.
I mean, but these are assigned places.
Mm-hmm.
In the system of white supremacy, no non-white people go, except where the white supremacists tell them they must be.
Mm-hmm.
They must be. This is why they set all the borders on the planet. They determine whose border is valid and whose border is not, because they set the borders. There are no borders for the white supremacists. They go where they please.
When they want to, yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. They don't have, you know, we call it the white community, but that doesn't make sense. I mean, you know, naturally you have a white world, all right, and the black people are just shuffling around in it to assign places. And so the so-called redlining is just say, that just means that, okay, we're going to have a city, we're going to build a whole new city in the middle of the desert. Okay, so when they do that, they say, now, in this city, we're going to have some people of color. So, hey, over here on the northeast side is where they're going to be. And you better believe that's exactly where you're going to be. I call it, so people will remember, the shack by the track with the room in the
back. Yeah, that's what it was, yeah.
That's under economics.
Mm-hmm.
That has to do with a suggestion that black people should have. If you can, you can't always do it because you don't have enough space for yourself. But if you can, always try to have a room set aside and all like that for somebody who finds, who gets on hard times.
Mm-hmm.
A basement space or something where someone who's just going through a little difficulty, if you can spare the space, I mean, let them have that space. If you have a house and you have a little, what you might call, you have enough money to have a little guest house out back and whatnot, I mean, you might have a cousin or somebody
who has
been set out and all like that. And if you're on excellent terms with that cousin and whatnot, always have that little space set aside.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just don't pile up a whole bunch of junk in that place where you can say, you know what, we can clean out this place, and that'll be a little room for, you know, Hattie Mae.
Mm-hmm.
You know, or when she gets out of, you know, because she doesn't, when she gets out of college this year, she really doesn't have any place to go because their house burned down, okay, and right at the time she was coming out of college. So, you know, so let Hattie Mae, that's one of our cousins, let her come over there and stay in that place out back. See, and the reason I mentioned that shack by the track with the room in the back, in the old days when I was coming up, there weren't a whole lot of what you call black people who were what you call homeless. I mean, you know, they really weren't. They, you know, they, or rather, I prefer to call it houseless, on account of those little shacks by the track with the room in the back. And I actually experienced that when I was in Chicago years ago, and winter was coming. And some people had been laid off from their jobs. And I noticed some of the fellows were saying who came from down south, they say, yeah, but I got me a Greyhound bus ticket that I've been holding on to just in case. And so, you know, I knew my job might play out at the factory. So now it's getting cold in Chicago. Our winters are brutal.